flow. Basketball is my favorite.
The first weekend of the MNBL, and all eight teams are looking even. I am your host, the Dudster, Nesta Dudley, and I am here with the coaches of a dynasty that was absolutely perfect. I'm here with Bernaco Stroud, Jovan Walcott.
Hey.
Gentlemen, welcome to Around the Rim.
Thanks for having us once again, man.
Before we start the show, I have to make a correction, and the correction involves the perfect dynasty. Last week, I said Jimmy Shue. I didn't say Jimmy Shue. I said Ali Joseph left as the greatest winner in the Mall Neighborhood Basketball League. He spent his entire career, as you guys know, he didn't receive one L. I thought Jimmy Shue was a senior. When I was looking at the rosters, I'm like, where's Jimmy Shue? Did he not sign up? You guys told me he graduated.
Yeah.
So Jimmy Shue and Ali Joseph will go down as the greatest winners in the Malden Neighborhood Basketball League. So whenever I make a faux pas up here, I like to correct it. And I just want to apologize for something that has nothing to do with the Hawks. Last weekend, last Sunday, there was a game between the Celtics and the Sonics. And everyone is asking about the dunk that Andy Williams did over Dakota Pellegrini. First of all, we all know when somebody got ups, you don't challenge, you do not jump.
Nope,
if you're going to jump, you better make sure you get that ball, foul him, something.
Yep.
In the NBA, they call it posterization. So folks who were here, who were there, have it in their memory. You have to keep it in your memory because for the first time in 3 years, the computer that I recorded it on froze up. So I had a force quit. For all those who know about MacBook Pros, I had a force quit. And when you force quit in a MacBook Pro, it shuts down everything that has not been saved. And since I couldn't save it because it was frozen, it doesn't exist. That whole entire second half doesn't exist. What can I tell you? Ain't my fault. Ain't my fault, Bernaco.
That's a shame, man.
And once it wasn't my fault.
It wasn't your fault either. It wasn't Brad's fault. It was nobody's fault. Them's the breaks. Yeah. But any case.
Maybe the dunk never happened.
Well, on with the show. As I said, coaches of a dynasty, that was perfect. And if you guys watched the show last week, and I'm hoping that you guys did, old Nesta predicted that you guys were going to take the whole damn thing.
Well, yeah, tough road.
Nesta predicted, not you guys.
Yeah, I watched the show, man. So I saw when you predicted that, man. And I don't know, man. when you did it, I caught it because I was sitting down, relaxing on the recliner.
Uh-huh.
And then when you're going through the names and everything, and then the Hawks ain't on the floor yet, and I'm like, wait a minute. You know, and then you had us going against the Sixers in the championship. I'm like, hold up. And then you said the Hawks win. I'm like, it was just kind of.
It was a whirlwind.
Yeah.
I base everything on the Jamboree, gentlemen, as you know. And you guys had put such a beating on the Lakers, almost shut them out in the second half. I could have sworn there was 12 guys on that.
It's only seven.
Yeah, it was only seven. You guys did that with seven.
It's only going to be seven.
Now, going to be seven, which is unfortunate. But, you know, plenty of minutes.
Yeah.
There's going to be plenty of minutes for everybody. So had I known it was seven, maybe the predictions would have been a little bit different. Maybe I might not have said you took, taking the whole damn thing. I probably still would have put you in the madness. But you know what? Just prove me right. Go out there and get that title.
Hey, I mean, the boys try, man. You know, it's
they're playing hard though.
They are.
I think they play harder than almost any team, win, lose, or draw. But it's tough to play with seven. You only get five fouls and all that other good stuff, and we do what we can. We're gonna play tough every time we come out. So that's just what it's gonna be.
And we got some, young kids.
Yeah.
We got a couple sophomores now.
How many sophomores did you draft?
I want to say three.
We drafted, I believe.
Four. And we're missing two of them.
And two of them, yeah. Mm-hmm. One of them quit on us. Yeah. Well, both of them quit on us, actually.
Yeah.
So, it's funny, they didn't even get to see the squad before they quit, though. You know what I mean? They might have been the man on the squad or whatever.
Yeah.
They didn't even get to see none of that. They just quit. So. That's their loss, man. Shout out to Hector and Brian.
It certainly is their loss. And last week I had said that the players on the Hawks, they show me something that no other players on any of the seven teams do. They show me the heart. Again, I base it on the jamboree. Based on the jamboree, Pepe still had that swag. Kedion still had that swag.
Still got it.
They're not supposed to lose.
Still got it. You know.
I mean, that's how they feel. No matter who they got, they. I mean, especially Pep.
Who's running point now?
Yeah, I mean. Yeah. we're light on it. I mean, you know what I mean? Yes, I mean, Pep, he had to step up. He stepped up to me. He's more vocal this year as well. So I think he expects
you want
to
win. That's more vocal.
Yeah. And I mean, he leads by example, though, too. Yeah. So if he's out there, you know, diving on the floor or whatever, he expects the other guys to do the same thing, man. So shouts to Pep on that. You know.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, too bad about those other two. But, you know, seven, I mean, you know, there have been some teams in the past that have done some damage with seven.
Yeah,
but, I mean.
But two more bodies would be nice.
Yeah, two more bodies would be nice. Three
really
more bodies,
practice.
You know.
It's tough to get a practice going when you don't have 10 guys out there going up and down the floor and trying to show them different things with a defense against each other. But
with a seven-man squad. And three coaches on the coaching staff, that means you guys got to lace them up at practice.
Most of the time.
You know, can you guys still lace them up? You're in advanced in years. Not as advanced as mine. As me, I am recognizing that, but you're advanced in years.
That recovery
stage. Most of the
time.
Yeah, it's the next day.
It's the recovery stage. I mean, when you're out there, you feel like, yeah, I can do this and everything. And then when you get home, you realize, I shouldn't have done that.
You should never done it.
I should have passed that one, man.
You do what you can, man. You just, you know, get them to go and play hard. That's all we really can do, and that's what we do well. So we'll be ready to play come this weekend.
I seen a little bit of your practice last weekend, and practice still run the same.
Yeah.
You're still teaching them the game. You're still putting in plays. So none of that's going to change.
Yeah. I mean, that's what we do, man. That's what we do. We work hard. We run. And we're going to do that with no matter who we got. If we got 5 kids, 7 kids, 10 kids, 11, whatever. We stick to our guns, man, and hopefully they buy into it.
And that music you hear out there, that caught up in the MNBL web. We're doing it early this season, the second show. And I have coaches of the Perfect Dynasty, Bernaco Stroud, Jovan Walcott, and Webb, and I can ask them anything I want, and it may or may not have to do with the Bald Neighborhood Basketball League. But this question does have to do with the Bald Neighborhood Basketball League. Now that the 32 straight is over, 35, you count the three jamborees, I want to know, year one, when you guys are 5-0, 6-0, 7-0, that you guys think you could run that table. So you can say anything now because now it's ancient history. When I had you guys up here two seasons ago, I'm sorry, but I didn't believe you.
Me personally,
yes.
I felt we could run the table the first year. At one point, I can't remember what game it was. I called him and I said,
six.
It was game six.
Yeah. Game six. See, I knew you guys wouldn't come. I knew you wouldn't come with two seasons ago. Yeah, I know.
I gave him a call and I was like, yo, do you peep the rest of the schedule? We can run the table, man.
Yeah. And the first year, the schedule was good for us. Mm-hmm. We got a chance the first 2 weekends to play 4 games. And the way we practiced, for whatever reason, we were just rolling. All the kids were showing up each practice, and they have 4 games that come out 4-0. And we were talking in the gym, if we come out 6-0, you know, we can do something. And he called me like Sunday night, and we 6-0, man. You think we can? I'm like, shh.
Yeah, don't say that.
But then after, I think, the 9th game, that's when we started, like, these kids could do this.
Yeah.
25th year, we can knock this out. Yeah, it happened.
Now, last season, the first show, I made a statement that was asinine. My statement said that the Hawks are not going to be undefeated. I had you guys going. The Hawks are not going to be undefeated.
I believe
okay?
you.
You know?
Yeah, I did.
What Bradworth said last year was asinine, asinine, asinine. He said that you guys were going to come up a little short because, frankly, you guys were a little short.
Yeah.
So once again, when you guys were 6-0 last year, did you make that phone call and say, yo, we can roll again 32 straight?
Because
I didn't believe you last year. Now you can tell me the truth. It's ancient history now.
No.
Nah, we didn't. We didn't see us going undefeated until probably about the last couple of games when we said, all right, we have to go undefeated.
Yeah.
But we didn't see it coming from the beginning. We knew we were short, but we knew from jump that we was gonna run.
I was personally ready to just hurry up and lose the game. Because every time we get in the games, a lot of the games would start out because teams are coming at us. First quarter and a half. And then come second or third, end of second, going into third quarter, we do what we do. I'm like, are we ever going to lose a game going into ninth and tenth game? And then, 11th, 12th game, we're like, oh, we got to go undefeated now because if we lose, I don't know how we're going to recover from that this late in the season.
Yeah, in a lot.
I know I'm driving Go Ref Go crazy because I'm going over the segment, but I got one more question, Go Ref Go. We'll just take it out on the other pot.
Okay, you got it.
We'll just take it on the other pot. One question. I know you guys are telling me the truth now. Which team would win between the team that went 16-0 or the team that went 13-0? If you could clone Ali Joseph and he could play on both teams, which team would win? One game, take it all. Before you ask that question, remember now, 2 years ago, I said that the Hawks were going to go down as the greatest team of all time. And I stand by that, that year, 2010. No one could predict that the next year you were going to duplicate that feat.
I would say, and I mean, I love both teams.
Yeah.
But if I had to pick, and it would just be slight, probably by one.
Would it be an and one? It'd
probably be an and one. But I would go with the first year's team. Only because you had Console down there, you had Shane down there, you had Isaiah, who's the other big down there?
That was it.
Shane, Console, and Isaiah. Yeah. And who was the guards? It was Ali and Kyle. Yeah. Kyle. Yeah. I go with them by one.
And one.
Yeah.
I picked the first team too, and basically because the kids were even older. We even had a few more seniors plus, a bigger size team. And the first year we were going through teams by 20 plus each game. Mm-hmm. We had one bad game, and we call a bad game winning by less than 10.
Yeah.
But we were coming out and just personally going through teams. So I picked the first team in overtime by one.
Okay. Gentlemen, you are out of the web. Go Ref Go, I had to go longer because I knew in the 2010 season they wasn't telling me the truth. They were massaging the truth. In the 2011 season, they were massaging the truth. But come on, we are all human. If you're sitting there 6-0, 7-0, 8, it has to be running in your head. Now, I know you're telling your players to slow your roll. Yeah. But you guys are at home saying, we got this.
Yeah.
I just knew this. So, hey, Waldo, we got on time. Is it time for the Rollins or? Oh, time for, okay. Well, let's go. Well, we have to be exactly on 1 minute. Whatever you.
We need a couple. We need a couple.
You need a couple? Okay, you need a couple. So
we need a couple back here.
We're getting ready to go into the Rollins. Again, this is the second show of the season, and this is live. Speaking about live, did you know that we're streaming live on the web? You go to atrlive.com to the right hand. Down below, it says live web stream, so guys can see this all over the planet.
Okay.
So Proctor, wherever he's at playing baseball somewhere, is probably watching the show right now saying, yeah, our team got it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I hope he is. What's up, Shane?
Hey, yeah. Shane. Hey, shout out to the eighth grade girls playing right now, 7:15 at the Salemwood School.
So Go Ref Go, let's go into the roller. So Go Ref Go, I'm not commentating, so we're going to play that planet rock, and you know how I like it, Go Ref Go.
They got Jovan's name as Jovan Osborne. I saw it on the screen.
Sorry, they know who I am.
Thank you.
And that's what happened this past weekend's play at the Fairway. And now it's time, I got my rundown right here, and now it's time for the weekly Around the Rim Awards. So let's kick it! Still waiting to kick it! Can I get a kick it? Player of the Week, Nelai Aiden of the Sonics. Nelai tied the record of three-pointers Sunday against the Celtics. 9 in the game. Everyone's talking about that dunk, but he tied the record. But you know why he also gets Player of the Week? In that same game, he went 4 from 4 at the line where everything is free, at the free throw line. Gentlemen, you know that any jerk can jack up a three. And we got a lot of jerks jacking up threes. So it doesn't even matter that he tied the record to me. 4 for 4 at the line where everything is free. Player of the Week, Nelai Aiden. Coach of the Week, Bernaco Stroud. Why? We know that the streak is broken. And you were, and you, Jovan, were like, let's get on the show. Let's talk about it. You know, let's talk about it. We're not running from anything. And that's big ups, because there are some coaches that probably wouldn't be. You think they could be any games up here? No, they ain't gonna happen. If he was in that spot, he'd be the last person to come up here. But I'm gonna shout Coach of the Week. Team of the week, giving it to the Kings. The Kings came back from behind. They almost shut out the Celtics in the second half of regulation, forced the game to go overtime. Kings with their first victory, and if you ask Cliff Williams, that was an upset. And Woo of the Week goes to the Magic Man, Evans Revere. He went into the cable cast booth and helped out recording the games. He also has a Twitter account. You guys know I got a Twitter account? That's the deadly map. Do you guys tweet?
Yeah.
Follow me. You gotta follow me. Magic has a Twitter account. He followed me. He actually showed me some stuff. I only opened the account like a day before. So he actually showed me some stuff. You know, you guys are youngest to me. You youngest know all about that stuff. I still gotta learn that part of the social media. But anyways, Magic Man, this woo is for you. Woo! And now, in respect for the coaches of a dynasty that was perfect, I'm not showing the standings this week. I'm not showing the standings this week.
Show
them. I'm not gonna show. Okay, right. So let's go to the wrap-up pages. This week's game, Saturday, the first game is the Sonics up against the Kings. Second game, Bullets, Celtics. Third game, Pistons, Lakers. And that third game is the rematch of the 2011 March Madness. Sunday's game, first game is Lakers, Hawks. Second game, Sixers, Bullets. And the third game is Pistons, Kings. And that first game, the grand people are watching. Bernaco Stroud knows what that means. Around the Rim, when you watch the show, every Thursday night, live 7 to p.m., plus live web stream on atrlive.com at 7 p.m. This show replays every Friday night, 10 in the p.m., replays Tuesday afternoons, 4 in the p.m., and replays Wednesday's morning, 11:30 a.m. When to watch them? The games, every Tuesday through Thursday on Channel 15, Comcast 24, Verizon, educational channel. And where to read them? In the Marlin Evening News. And if you're too cheap, to spend 75 cents, you can go to the official website of the Marlin Neighborhood Basketball League. That's mnbl19.tripod.com.
What was that, cheap?
Excuse me?
What was that, too cheap or cheap?
Cheap to spend the 75 cents. Or you can go to the online show, that's hrlive.com. You can like us, the show, on Facebook. Facebook.com/AroundTheRim. Or you can follow us at Nestor Dudley, the Twitter. Nestor Dudley, tweet me! You guys got a Twitter account, set it up. You got to follow Nestor. I need followers. Tweet me!
Nestor, I'm surprised you're on Facebook and Twitter. I'm surprised.
The show, ATR, is on Facebook, and I'm on Twitter. Go, Ref, go. Do you have a Twitter account?
Of course I do.
Well, you got to follow me. Tweet me! Waldo, you got a Twitter account? You do? Are you following me yet? Don't lie. You're not following me yet. Follow me, Waldo. Tweet me! That's what we're gonna be here on, gentlemen. Tweet me.
Oh, man.
So this season, you're not gonna go undefeated. We already know that. But you know, what do you look forward to this season? I mean, I still think that you guys can make damage. It's only the first weekend. I still think that you guys can go to the Madness.
I mean, I
didn't mean to get you speaking in tongues.
We're just looking forward to this weekend, man.
We just gotta take it 1 week at a time, game at a time, 1 quarter at a time. It's gonna be a
challenge, man. Yeah. You know, having 7 guys, we got young guys, but we're gonna have fun doing it. No matter the record or all that good stuff, that's the team.
And remember what I told you guys on the last show last year. No matter how next year works out, which is this season, mm-hmm. it doesn't matter because you guys are sitting there with home and away jackets.
Yeah.
You got some hardware. Yeah. You know, yeah. Nice ones too, by the way. But yeah, you know, that trophy don't go back to whoever. You know, wins the title until March, so the mm-hmm. trophy sits right.
And that trophy can very well be sitting where it's sitting right now.
Hey, you know, you never know.
You never know.
It is the only trophy, you know, never to leave the gym when it's brought in the gym on championship day. It's never been taken home by anybody else. Brought it in the gym, take it right back home with us. It can happen again, but you never know. It's a long shot. We'll see.
And like I said, it could happen. How much time we got, Ref? 3 minutes. Oh, Waldo, what am I going to talk about for 3 minutes? You guys got any shout-outs you had mentioned about a basketball game?
Well, hey, you know, we got our daughters in the 8th grade basketball team.
Shout them
travel
out.
Travel team. Janaea Walcott
and Cedar Stroud.
They're playing right now at the Salemwood School, and we're going to race there once this is all wrapped up and see how they're doing.
Oh, so I took you guys away from your daughters?
Don't even worry about that.
We only missing like 15 minutes. And shout-outs to my daughter, Asia. Okay. She plays ball, too, now.
What position do your daughters play?
I think they're both forwards right now. About. Yeah.
Asia, obviously, she'll
call
be a
her
guard.
The point guard.
Yeah,
point guard of the future.
Does she got them handles? Did you teach her the crossover?
She can dribble.
Did you teach the cross?
I'm trying to teach her to go left to right, man. But she goes to this thing YBG and out in Melrose now. Uh-huh. So, she's learning. She's doing good.
And what's their record? Same team, right?
I want to say they just won 4 games in
a row. Yeah, so they're 4-3.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so they're on a little. 4 game winning
streak right
now. They're man.
Doing all right.
Have you guys ever thought about taking over their team?
We try to work with them every now and then.
Yeah.
But
are they paying attention? You know how they don't want to listen to pops.
They pay attention, but
recently, as you know, they finally see they come to our games. And they see us win a couple or 32 games.
Yeah.
Now, I think the two dads might know a little bit what they're talking about when they talk basketball. So they're starting to listen.
Right. Yeah.
They're doing okay.
We work them every now and then. You know, they get aggravated, but.
they get aggravated all the time. But they're doing all right. They play pretty good down there. They got a good little team.
As you guys know, I have a daughter, Conchester, and she gets aggravated a lot. And I can guarantee you, she gets aggravated more than your two daughters put together.
Oh, no, I got 18-year-old, so once she gets 18, we can talk about that. We got a car and all that other good stuff. You know, I don't even want to talk to you, but once you need your car fixed, hey, Dad, can you change my oil or something like that? But you'll see when they're 18. You'll see. She's coming. Watch.
Well, Joe, but I want to thank you again for being on the show. Bernaco Stroud, Jovan Walcott.
Good to see you.
It's a pleasure having you guys up here.
Thank you for having us.
And hopefully you guys be up here in the 1 hour All Madness special. You
never
just
know.
You just don't know. Mm-hmm. You ain't got to be sitting in seat one.
It's 1 hour now?
It's what? Well, the Madness special, not the last show.
I'm sorry.
Yeah,
I'm
the coaches.
I'm sorry.
You ain't got to be sitting in seat one. You can sit in seat 4, 3, or 2. Don't matter.
You never know.
Don't matter. But you could be in seat one.
You never know.
I just want to say, until next time, buenas noches, hoochas, coochas. I came in peace. I leave with love. This is for the red, the black, and the green. And I will be seeing youths at
They're
the game.
They're playing basketball.
They're hot.
We love that basketball. They're playing basketball. We love that basketball. They're playing basketball. We love that basketball. They're playing basketball. We love that basketball.
travel up and down the court, just like I'm the king on the microphone. So is Dr. J and Moses Malone. I like slam dunks, take me to the hoop.